Right. Can you all hear me now? Sorry, my fault. I forgot to turn on the microphone. That happens. Let me just check if it's now not going to turn off as well. Hang on. Yeah. Okay, I think I've got it now. My apologies. So, what was I saying? I hope you're all doing well after the weekend. And that you managed to keep some sort of a practice up, whether it is to keep your spirits high and to keep your vital energy going in your body. Super important. You keep your vital energy, flowing and strong. Super important to stay healthy, but most of all, important to stay positive. I kind of noticed myself today feeling a bit more emotional around this whole thing. It just happens, you know, sometimes you're so busy with keeping things going and looking after other people that you're not so into it. And then there comes a moment in this time where the severity of the situation sort of dawns on you. And it's dawned on me a little bit, but today a little bit more. And I just want to say how important it is when you feel things like that to actually take time to feel them and not to run away from them. So I really took a moment to breathe those feelings in and to send healing to everyone on the outbreath, because what hit me most is not my situation, I'm fine, but what hit me is the amount of people I know that are suffering, and it is big in the world, and there is lots of people sick or losing loved ones or living in circumstances that are not optimal. You know, they're either going through it alone or they're in awful houses, or children being abused, not being able to get out. I mean, there's a lot going on. So I don't want to make you depressed, but I do want to be true about the situation we're in. And I do want to keep reminding you to not push away these feelings and to use the meditation we did last week, the sending and taking meditation, where you breathe in the suffering and you send out the love and the healing and the wish for healing to people and to yourself, so that you process these feelings and show up for them and turn towards them rather than pushing them away. This is the only way you can keep your heart open. So that's what I did today. I noticed I had to, because I was coming to that point where I was going to go, oh, I don't want to feel this. And then I'm just, when I notice myself doing that, I turn around and face it. And I hope you do too. So our meditation today will also be that we tune again into our emotional life, but then we start leaving it alone so that we can settle, which is just as important, is that we also leave our body to do what it does best, and that is get back to balance, and our mind when we are present and we are holding it and at the same time not interfering. So that was my little talk today. So I'd like to now start with some movements. So if you like, actually come and sit on your knees. If sitting on your knees isn't comfortable, sit cross-legged. Place your hands on your thigh bones and just press a little the thigh bones down as you begin to lift your spine out of your hips. Great. And then release. Inhale, take your arms up. And exhale, release the shoulders down for a moment. And then inhale, pressing your lower legs down, pressing the tops of the toes down and reach up. And exhale, slowly sliding the shoulder blades down the back with your elbows bent. Inhale, lift up. And exhale, sliding it down. Inhale, up. And sliding it down. And then sit a little bit more wide and more stable. And then you can just bring your right arm and just move it along the horizon. Big circles with the focus on the shoulder, around the shoulder, the fascia in the upper body. Feeling the sliding and the gliding. And also one time back. Right, and take your right arm out and then bring both arms together, right arm underneath. Lift the elbows for a moment. And exhale, allowing the arms to come down
Your head to come down. Feel the stretch between the shoulder blades. Feel the weight of the arms. Breathe into the upper back. And let go.
Other side. So left arm. Moving it across the horizon, along the horizon as much as possible. Your right arm is there to really support you making this movement. And breathe deep. Breathing deep is another way for our energy to not get stuck. And move other one way around to the other side. And then take your left arm out to the side, right arm out to the side, left arm underneath the right. First, lift your elbows, keep your hands a little away from the face. Lift the chest, and then exhale. Allow your head to drop the shoulders. Feel the weight of the arms on the upper back hanging. Breathe between the shoulder blades in the upper back. And let go, come up. Good, take a moment to close your eyes and just feel. And with your eyes closed, how do you know you've got arms and that you've got shoulders and you've got an upper body? And you know because there is a sense of aliveness there. Because you feel life moving through your body. And it can be super subtle and it can be quite clear. It doesn't really matter. But it's nice to become aware of this. This is something to become aware of all day if you can. It's just that sense of aliveness within. Much more interesting than thinking the same thoughts all day or becoming negative. This is your way out. Okay. Take your left hand down. Inhale, take your right arm up. And exhale, just take a gentle opening in the side body. Make it feel good. Take a deep breath and change arms. Gentle opening in the side body. Inhale. And come back up. Okay, come onto all fours. And just here, with a little bit of a twist, you can just bring one elbow down and then look over the left shoulder if you bring your right elbow to the floor. Inhale, come up. Left elbow to the floor. Look over the right shoulder. And then begin to kind of do your own thing a little bit. I like extending my arm. And maybe keeping both arms on the mat, circling your rib cage from side to side in big circles. So it's the almost vertical circles. And go the other way. Sort of feel into your body and intuitively get moving into those spaces that feel tight or stuck. And remind yourself to now and then take a deep full breath. And tuck your toes under. Inhale, place your hands a little further forward. And exhale, gently press yourself back. Press the heels back, lift the knees. And feel the sensations in the backs of the legs. Make sure the upper body is stable by having your hands in a position that your shoulders feel free, the neck is free. And you feel strong in the upper back. And then begin to walk your legs out. Relax your jaw. Deep breath in and a sigh out. You don't always have to do deep breathing when you do yoga. It's just in this situation when we get stressed or we feel low or we don't know what to do with ourselves. Basically, our breath stops or it becomes very shallow. And that's why I let you breathe deeply, because when we breathe deep, we also release tightness and tension. A bit of a sigh. Okay. And then walk your feet to your hands. Let your whole body dangle for a moment. Head heavy, arms heavy. Bend those knees. Take your right arm up. Place the left fingertips on the floor for a twist. Inhale. Exhale. Bend your knees deep. Come a little bit into a squat. And right hand down. Take your left arm up as you straighten the legs a little. The left leg straight is a bit more, right leg stays nice and bent. Exhale, and we move in between those two. Inhale into your twist. When you twist to the right, the left knee is nice and bent. Exhale, squatting down to the floor. Inhale, twist to the left. Exhale, come close to the floor. Feel the solidity, the stability, and open it up into a twist. Two more times. And back down. Good. And then place your hands in your side. From your lower belly, press out through your feet. Keep your knees bent. Inhale, come up with a straight back. And exhale, release your arms. Take a moment to feel your body. Take a moment to feel your heart. And shift to how you feel. How you feel about your body, how you feel about being here right now. How you feel about being you right now. Alive. And then begin to circle your hips. You can keep your eyes closed. I like to keep my eyes closed for the moment. Circle your hips around. You can have your hands on your hips, supporting the circle if you like, or anything else is good. And I want you to really feel into your hips when you do this. And circle the other direction. It's so important to keep all the joints moving so energy can flow through them. Okay. And then place your weight onto your left leg. Open your eyes for this one. And take a point on eye level. And then lift the right knee up. And then take that right knee out. And then place your foot either on the inside of your left thigh. You can do that without your hands. Or place your foot on the inside of your left calf. And then bring the palms together. Keep your eyes focused on a point. A little bit away from you on the floor or eye level. Breathing is soft, eyes are relaxed, jaws relaxed. Squeeze your right foot and left inner thigh a little together or with your calf. Take your arms out wide for a moment. Open the chest, take life in, and exhale. Bring that energy back into your heart. Release your right leg, other side. So place it down, spread your toes. Keep looking at that point on eye level or on the floor away from you. Lift your left knee up, take it out. And place your foot on the inside of your left thigh or lower your calf. Of course, you can also help with your hand later to bring your foot up. Palms together. Soften. And if you're playing the piano with your foot, that's pretty normal. Or if you're falling out, that's normal too. You just come back. Open the chest. Eyes stay soft. Inhale, take your arms wide. Open yourself to your surrounding, to each other. And exhale, bring the energy of your surrounding in towards your heart. The energy of the world, of the earth, of each other. And release when you're ready. Okay. Shake out both legs. Shake them out vigorously. Shake out your arms and your hands. And then come to the floor because we're going to do a bit of breathing before we start our meditation. So you might want to get comfortable. So you can sit on a chair as well. Remember at home, don't need to be sitting on a meditation pillow. And you can sit any way you wish, as long as you can sit up with a straight spine in your own strength and your chest can be open as well. So make it comfortable. And I'd like to introduce the breathing, the 4-7-8 breath. So that means we breathe into 4, we hold the breath for 7, and we exhale to 8. And this just helps to relax the system. Yeah. So when you get anxious for whatever reason, of course, deep breathing helps, slow, deep breathing, but also the 4-7-8 breath helps. So that's the one I want to do now before we start meditating. So from there, we move straight into our meditation. So I'm going to count for you. You breathe into 4, you hold for 7, and we exhale to 8. We breathe in through the nose, we hold the breath with our mouth closed, and we exhale gently out through the mouth. Okay. Exhale gently. Start your in-breath. 1, 2, 3, 4. Hold. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Out through the mouth. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4. Hold. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Out. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. In. 2, 3, 4. Hold. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Out. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Keep going. And then find your own rhythm a little bit. Maybe you need to make your count to go a little faster because you got out of breath. Maybe you can slow your count. But it's 4, 7, 8. So I'm going to leave it with you because we all have a little bit different lungs. Some of you may have a cold or anything like that. So adapt. I'll join you for 4 cycles and then we'll stop. I won't count. So into 4, hold for 7, out to 8. In through the nose, out through the mouth. One last round. Wonderful. And then prepare for your meditation. So allow the breath to find its natural rhythm. Relax your whole body. Remember the points that I was talking about last week a lot that helps you to release and relax your nervous system really quickly. Relax your eyes and the space behind your eyes till deep within the brain. Relax the root of the tongue. Your mouth, jaws. And relax your heart. And then your waist and your belly. Relax the waist and the belly. Feel gravity have you. Feel the floor. Consciously release the weight to the floor, to the support you feel from underneath. Somewhere underneath the floor is the earth. Feel the solidity and the stability of the earth. Feel how the earth is always there. No matter what you're thinking is happening, still there's always the earth underneath your feet somewhere. And this is a relief. knowing this. So tune into this magnificent piece of earth that is always there for us. That always supports us, keeps our heart beating, gives us oxygen. You can make that a little broader, make it life. Tune into life. The space around you, how that is always there, supporting you, holding you. Never judges, always loving. And that same space that is around you, holding you, is the same space that is surrounding all of us right now that are meditating. And there's quite a number of us. So take a moment to reach out from your heart into that space, knowing all of our hearts reaching out into that same, and it's the same space, the same stillness. Creating a field of light, of love, for ourselves, for each other, and for the people around us who need it. When we can tune into love and tune into peace, people feel that, we carry that with us, and people around us feel that, so it ripples out. So give yourself that every day, it's the best you can do. And from that love, see if you can get in touch with any kind of emotion that's there too. Maybe it's just love, that's fine, you can stay with that. I can immediately feel a deep sadness too. And I also want to be with that. I want to give that space. Because I know if I can give that space, my entrance to love is also much bigger. And I can let both be there. There's nothing between me and life, between me and love. But it's different for everyone. Sometimes you are in touch with sadness, sometimes you're not. Sometimes it's just light. It's all just perfect. Just be there for it, show up for it. You can be with it. Trust that. You can be with it. You can always be with the situation as it presents itself. What you cannot possibly be with is an idea of the next moment, because it's not there. So stay rooted in the present moment. There's only ever this moment in time. So let's set up this connection with each other, this holding space, that it's okay to be with all those feelings underneath the surface, so that they're all allowed to be there, so that we become open, an open vessel for also the love that is, that has the same ground. To feel love, we need to go through our messiness. There's no other way. We need to open ourselves to it. And when we do that together, it's a beautiful thing. And from your heart, still feel into that field that we create together, into life, into love. And if there's someone in your life that you know has a hard time, and it can be yourself, that's okay. So for those of you who are going through a tough moment, yourselves, take yourself. For those of you who have the strength at the moment to send some love to someone else, take someone else to mind that needs it. And see them well. So the way you send loving kindness, you share your loving kindness with someone, is by seeing them well, not by seeing them struggling in your mind's eye when you do this meditation, but by seeing them well, by seeing them healthy. So also see yourself well, if you take yourself. See yourself settled. And able to be with life as it comes your way. See other people settled and coping well. In touch with the light in their hearts. In touch with the space that holds them, aware of the support of that space of life. And then let's send all of our love to everyone, to the people we had in our minds, to ourselves, to the group. And to the world as a whole, may all beings everywhere be peaceful. May all beings everywhere, without exception, be in touch with the light in their hearts. Be in touch with the space around them that holds them. May all beings everywhere be free of suffering, at least the suffering that we add to the situation with the mind. There is inherent suffering in the world that we cannot move away from, but we make it so much worse with our mind. So may all beings be free of that part of the suffering. Feel the heart. And from the heart with gentleness, feel your whole body. So come back to yourself now. From the heart, feel your head, your neck, shoulders and arms and hands. Feel your whole torso, hips and legs and feet. See yourself well, able to be that light also for other people. When you're in touch with your own peace, that's noticeable. And all you need to do is stay true to yourself and allow whatever is there to be there and hold it in a safe place. Bring the palms together. May all beings everywhere, without exception, be peaceful and happy. Deep in breath. Exhale, bow the head to the wisdom of the heart. And gently come out of it. Open your eyes. Okay. So, I hope is that that half an hour every day just helps you to get closer to what's really going on inside of you. Because again, that is the only way to the softening enough inside so you can open yourself again to the love that is always there. Yeah? The connection with each other, the life, the feeling of life that is always there. And just pushing away a certain part of us. When you push one thing away, you push a whole range of things away. If you push one emotion away, you push all emotions away. When you push fear away, you push love away. So show up for all of it and with gentleness and staying stable with the instability at times. If you feel you lose the stability, then it's time to do something else for you. Yeah. So I hope you enjoyed that and I hope you'll be back tomorrow. The only thing I wanted to say, I think, is we put the ads on the live videos, but afterwards. And we chose not to do that before, but we choose to do it now because we want to give the proceeds to the Red Cross. So everything we earn on the ads of these videos is for the Red Cross because they really need it. So we decided that's what we do. And if you, so please, the more people that watch it, the better for you. All the people and yourselves, but also for the Red Cross. And I think that's really important right now. Thank you all for joining me. And I'll be there again tomorrow at 5:00. Namaste.